next day. And in my mind, I don't know, those of you who knew Ronnie, you may understand, taken the best way, that she was a tough lady. She was lovely, but she was always determined. She was always very protective of her clients. And the dealing that I had was on behalf of a client of hers, and she was wanting to make sure that her client was going to be taken care of the way she thinks that he should be. And I remember saying to myself when I'm calling her the next day, and I'm almost having rehearsing conversation, I say, Ronnie, you're going to have to make up your mind today. I want an answer today, because I've been dealing with this for a number of days prior to that. And I woke up and was up that morning at about 7:30 or 8 o'clock. I got a call from a friend, said, have you heard about Ronnie Chasen? And I hadn't yet heard about her because I hadn't listened to the radio at that time. And I was told, and it didn't register. And but the next thing that happened is that I suddenly said to myself, my God, here, the only thing I had in mind today was going to make sure that she gave me an answer. And I wanted, obviously, a positive answer. And suddenly, with this news, it suddenly made me realize once again that we need to live in the day, that you cannot always be overly concerned about whatever it is that you think is important or a benefit to me. And it all kind of washed away. And it took the better part of the day for me to kind of reconcile